I think that's a pretty old house. I think it used to be a schoolhouse.
Used to be.
I can show you where an old schoolhouse got burnt down. And I think right there used to be an old store. Right up here used to be a bar. But heck, that house has been there so long, it's starting to fall in. Heck, one of my friends, Roby, used to live in it. Heck, I used to help him chop wood and I watched him kill a chicken. So back there, it's probably the old mines. You can see a tire from here somewheres. That's around here. Oh, there it is. See it right there? It's the elevator for the dang mines.
These right here are my youngest right here, and I married 20 years ago, that's when I was real young. Back in high school when I met my first sweetheart. But I moved away from here when I was 18. And I come back and here I am again. Ivanhoe, it's a quiet place. It's nice. I mean, you can ride your bicycle and you didn't get no Yahoo. But in the earlier days, there's a place up here at the schoolhouse and everybody just getting fights. Now I'm talking about fist fights.
There's a place here across the country called the Bloody Bucket.
Yeah, the Bloody Bucket. Busters fight all down here.
That's been a long time ago, man.
Yeah,
that's before my time.
You know anything about a curse? On Ivanhoe?
No, only about how it started was, it said some preacher did it or something like that, heck if I know. So it said a preacher curse or something like that.
I'm Kay Early. I'm standing at 289 Painters Hill Road in Ivanhoe, Virginia. The significance of this place is that this is where Reverend Bob Sheffy is reported to have stood and put a curse on Ivanhoe in the late 1800s or early 1900s, I'm not for sure.
That was a traveling preacher, and he was one of the old horseback riding around type that come many, many years ago.
The reason he put the curse on Ivanhoe was because it was a mining town, and there was lots of drinking and gambling and houses of ill repute.
The Bible says that if somebody offends you, to take your shoes off and to shake the dust off. And when he got to the top of, I believe it was Church Hill, is what I've always been told, he took his shoes off and shook the dirt off of them, and he said, you know, he said, Ivanhoe would never be nothing. Whether, you know, you believe in it or not, after that happened, we lost everything. They lost the rock quarry, they lost the railroads, we lost the mines, we lost our stores, we had nothing.
Was fires everywhere. Older houses, just nobody living in them. And a lot of them got burned out.
And there's sinkholes starting to show up. Now, I mean, sinkholes that's starts out this big and goes this big. And up here at this house up here, it scared me. I was mowing the yard when I lived up there, and there was a hole this big, and I stepped on it, and the hole went like this.
See, one house actually got sucked in, and said the only thing that was sticking out was the just the tip of the roof.
There were lead mines here. The National Carbide came in, and then New Jersey Zinc came into Austinville. And later on, they came and started mining on this side of the river. Austinville's on the other side of the river.
That's me and Jack Rose. We're loading on 1,200. We're filling the mining cars. Each car held 12 tons.
Yeah, my leg.
There's Glenn and Johnny drilling what they call a head and run. Really, down through the years, I guess over 100 years, my people's been in the mines, just right around here.
But then they decided they wanted to do a pay cut on the miners. And the miners was like, you know, they wouldn't have nothing to do with that because that's a dangerous job. They were constantly getting hurt. You have, you know, the same chances of getting black lung from zinc and lead as you do from coal. So because they wouldn't take a pay cut and the union wouldn't break up, they decided to flood them.
It was a sad time because a lot of the guys that I knew and a lot of guys I worked with, see, they were almost at retirement age and they couldn't get a job. People just wouldn't hire them. Well, they never did get a job after the mines closed down. They just had to struggle till they got old enough to draw their Social Security.
Working at a garage part-time and just trying to hold on what we got. We own this place. So, I mean, it's a family place, and we took it over, and she's cleaning it up and taking care of it and everything else. But hopefully, with the year turning around, I'll get back myself back into business and maybe get back up to standards.
We're mountain people, and we're Appalachian, and we're deep bred into these mountains, and we're so afraid that's why they won't let people come in and help them. It's because they're so afraid people's come in before and they took stuff away. You know, they brought all these industries into Ivanhoe and they made Ivanhoe a wonderful place. And then the same people that brought it in took it back out.
Always stay close to your brush on your right-hand side, okay? I got him in a scope now. You make sure that you're not shooting towards a highway like the guy over here on a tractor. I wouldn't want to be shooting that way, but this is just a demonstration. That deer was there. Right here was where I would get him.
The day before Thanksgiving, we always kill two of the pigs, and our neighbors kill two of the pigs. And a lot of men come down and help us, and we'll cut them, and we make the bacon, the fat back, and the ham and stuff. And we keep that, and We'll have the ham and stuff for Christmas, and then we'll use the rest of it throughout the year. It's much better than store-bought food.
People, God give us the greatest piece of real estate on earth, America. And it's something to celebrate. I'm a Klansman. I'm the Imperial Wizard of the Virginia Knights of the Ku Klux Klan. We believe in God. We put God first. The Klan lights a cross to show Jesus is the light of the world. We wear the blood drop. That's the blood drop Jesus shed on the cross for us. That's the blood drop that all of our forefathers shed in all the wars. That's the blood we spent. We wear the blood drop on our road. We're a Christian organization.
Yeah, I'm going.
It was hard. Yeah, it was really hard. And our parents always taught us not to fight. So we had a hard time with that because when we were behind her back, we did take up for ourselves. We didn't take trash off of nobody. And it was hard, but I think it was due a lot to the parents because it's like the children, they could get along, but it's like the parents, you know, just the way you're brought up and the way you're taught whenever you're growing up. And us, like us of color, it was hard because you didn't have the rights like you have now.
I just like the mountains. I like knowing who my neighbor is. You know, I like being able to come and go at night and not necessarily worried about whether or not you're going to get attacked. I just like the small town life.
It was a town that was abandoned by the great company, by the big companies, but we made it anyway, because that's what communities do. You stay together and pull for each other.
My papa's brother pulled 7 years in state penitentiary for attempted murder. And my papa pulled 6 years in state penitentiary for cutting a boy. He was younger when he done it, but he cut him in Ivanhoe.
But we're not the baddest people in the world by no means.
There's bad people out there.
But it means that you take up for your family.
Like I said,
to me,
you know,
I think you should.
Well, I mean, it gives you a reputation, just like Shane's family too. I mean, like I said, everybody from around here, hard knocks. It's hard to hurt us.
I can take a whipping.
But
I think it's more about protecting your kids and your daggone mother and father and your grandparents more than anything. It ain't even about me. I can take it myself. She can jump on me. But jump on my kid or something or my grandma, that's different, you know? It should be.
And they give meth a bad name. Some of that crank has helped people. I've seen it help people. If it's good, well, they work, it helps you work better and everything. I'm not saying I'm a crankhead. I've done crank, but may do it again. But still, I'm not a maker of it, and I'm not a drug dealer really. I think it's like a medicine. If you're real tired, you can do your bump of crank and go on. If it's good.
I ain't, boy.
to live in this area, you have to be a strong person. Because a weak person would never survive how to live around here. Because, you know, you go without so much. You have to work. There's no slackers in Ivanhoe. You cannot slack and survive here in Ivanhoe. And, you know, we have a strong backbone because we've been put down so much. Oh, here comes the Ivanhoe trash. You know, no, I'm not trash. There's not a part of my body. My child's not trash. My mama's not trash. My daddy's not trash. And when you're talking about Ivanhoe, that's who you're talking about. You're talking about my blood.
This is my 4th of July picture from 3 years ago, because I always carried the flag in the parade. And this year I'm going to be riding the lawnmower in the parade, but I'm going to do exactly the same outfit and stuff. And so the title of this is, where is it, Mom? Fourth and Long. And so I wanted to get exactly as close as I could to that year's.
But they're all going to be in the parade. I guess Jake, well, she's kind of camera shy. You see him, he's running off. And last year, he rode the four-wheeler.
Yeah, I need to loosen up, too.
Of course, then again,
I just need to loosen up.
He was riding his Uncle Charlie's four-wheeler, and he burned it up.
That we live in a free country, that we can do this. Be blessed that you're in a country where you can go to church tomorrow morning and it doesn't matter what religion you are. Be blessed that we have this beautiful place and there's no bombs going off around us. And be blessed that this is a friendly community, that we try to bond together and we try to have wonderful things. So,
I grew up here, and it's really nice to see that it's still going on for my kids to see.
There you go.
We've been taking a poster around to have everybody sign. It's the first time my son has missed Ivanhoe Parade in years. He's overseas fighting for a country and letting us do what we're doing here. So everybody say hi and congratulations and thanks a lot. Come home safe. Love you.
Keep us on it.
The winner of the We Miss Jubilee pageant is Daisy Conley. Her hobbies are cheerleading, dress up, beauty pageants, dancing, and singing. Our junior Miss winner is Chloe Watts. She's 10 years old, 5th grade at Sheffy Elementary. Her parents are Brian and Desiree Watts, and her hobbies are quilting and reading.
Yay, Chloe!
Yeah. Woo! Camera, right here.
Economy's falling apart. Sickness on every hand. There's not much peace in the world today, but there is can be peace that rules our hearts in the midst of it all. We were talking this morning about joy and not having joy in times of suffering or times of calamity. But you know what? We can go through many things. And we may not be shouting or rejoicing at the time, but we have that peace of God that is ruling our heart, where that we don't fall apart, that we don't just sit down and give up, but that peace of God takes us through and helps us to come out on the other side. Oh, praise the Lord. Are you thankful for the peace of the Lord this morning, for the joy of the Lord?